In this video, I'm going to show you step by step how to log off users remotely using PowerShell. And we're starting right now. Hey, what's up, guys? This is Paul from the Sysadmin channel. And the first thing we're going to do is Google log off users Sysadmin channel so we can get the script. We'll go ahead and press enter to that. And now we'll be taken to the Sysadmin channel website. And from here, we'll simply scroll down so we can copy and paste our script. Once we have that copied, we'll go ahead and open up PowerShell ISE, and then we'll go ahead and paste it in there and copy it to the C_scripts folder that we created. We were able to save that with no problem, and now we'll go ahead and go over the script. So first things first, there are a couple of requirements to run this script. One of them is you need to have the Active Directory module installed on the computer that you're running it from. You need to have the PowerShell window run as administrator, and the script requires that PowerShell version 3.0 is installed. Anything after that is fine as well. Next up, we have our parameters. In this script, we're using the computer name parameter, username, logoff, and log errors parameters. Starting off with the computer name parameter, this allows a single computer or multiple computers in an array to be set as an input. The username parameter only accepts one input at a time, so we can easily filter by user objects if we needed to. With this script, we're not only given the option to not only list the user sections, but log them off if we choose to. The logoff switch parameter would be used if that were the case. Last but not least, this script provides the functionality to log errors with the log errors parameter. By default, the log file would be saved to the user's desktop, so we can check any errors with that option. Now into the heart of the script. This script basically checks the local or remote computer to see if there are any sessions using the Win32 process WMI command. Next, the script will do a query session to see if the user is logged on and output a neat table in our PowerShell window. So enough with the overview of the script. Let's go ahead and open up PowerShell and .source the function. As I mentioned before, the script does require administrative privileges, so it will not work. So let's go ahead and close that. Open up PowerShell as an administrator and .source the function once again, and we should be in the clear. That loaded up just as expected, so we'll continue on. Let's start off by calling the function get-users and logoff computers-computer name, and we'll call the computer names pack-sccm01, pack-win1001, and pack-1002. So by default, if no users are specified, it will look for the user that's running the shell. In this case, it's my pcontreras account. And we can see that I'm logged into pack-sccm01, pack-win1001. And you can notice that pack-1002 didn't show up because I wasn't logged onto that machine. So let's go ahead and up arrow this so we can get the last command and specify a username, D Jones. Looks like D Jones was not found on any of those machines. We'll go ahead and remove not online and enter in pack-win1002, and D Jones is logged onto that machine under session 6. Perfect. So what do you say we log off D Jones remotely? Yeah? After all, that's the whole reason why we created this script, isn't it? Let's go ahead and do that. So we'll up arrow one more time, but this time we'll specify the logoff parameter. But before I fire off this command, let's go ahead and check the pack-win1002 machine. We can see that D Jones is actually logged in. So let's go back into our computer and fire off that command. I should note that when you specify the logoff switch, it will display the username. However, it will also log them off. So we can verify that by checking on this pack-win1002 machine. And now there's no longer a user logged in. We'll run that command once again, and it should come up blank. Perfect. All right, so let's say we wanted to add an array of machines. Let's say you wanted to check all the servers in your organization. So here we'll want to get AD user and filter operating systems by servers. Actually, that's not going to come out with anything I messed up. It should be get AD computer. So we'll run a get AD computer and filter everything that contains server in the operating system. You can see right here, these are all the servers I have in my organization. I'm going to go ahead and pipe that to a sort object just so I have everything in alphabetical order. Perfect. So let's go ahead and run this command again, but this time instead of specifying single computers, let's go ahead and specify the servers array that we created earlier. We can see that my pcontreras account is logged on to just about every server in this test lab. All right, so now I want to log off my pcontreras account off of all those servers. So we'll go ahead and up arrow, and this time specify the logoff switch. And right now you can't see it, but in the background it is logging everyone off. What I will do though is rerun that command, and you can see that my user account is no longer logged on. All right, guys, in this video we went over logging off users remotely using my cool PowerShell script that I created. If you like this video, go ahead and give me a thumbs up and subscribe if you want more content like this. If you have any ideas for any other scripts you would like me to create, just let me know in the comments section and I'll try to get on that. Until next time, this is Paul with the SysAdmin Channel, signing out.